We can think of diagnosis as a mapping from a data space to a hypothesis space. In case of medical diagnosis, the data may be the various kinds of signs and symptoms that I might go to a doctor with. Some of the data may be very specific. Some of it may be very abstract. An example of very specific data is that Ashok's temperature is 104 degrees Fahrenheit. An example of an abstraction of the data is that Ashok is running a fever. The hypothesis space consists of all hypotheses that can explain parts of the observed data. A hypothesis in the hypothesis space can explain some part of the data. In case of medicine, this hypothesis may refer to diseases. A doctor may say that my hypothesis is that Ashok is suffering from flu and that explains his high fever. In the domain of car repairs, this hypothesis may refer to specific faults with the car. For example, the carburetor is not working properly. In the domain of computer software, this hypothesis may refer to specific methods not working properly. Now, this mapping from the data space to the hypothesis space can be very complex. The complexity arises partly because of the size of the data space, partly because of the size of the hypothesis space, partly because the mapping can be M to N, and also because these hypotheses can interact with each other. If H3 is present, H4 may be excluded. If H5 is present, H6 is sure to be present, and so on. It helps then not to deal with all the raw data, but to deal with abstractions of that data. So the initial data that a patient may go to a doctor with may be very, very specific, the signs and symptoms of that particular specific patient. But the diagnostic process may abstract them from Ashok has a fever of 104 degrees Fahrenheit to Ashok has a high fever. This abstract data then can be mapped into an abstract hypothesis. Ashok has high fever can get mapped into Ashok has a viral infection, for example. That abstract hypothesis can now be refined into Ashok suffers from flu or Ashok suffers from flu of a particular strain. At the end, we want a hypothesis that is as refined as possible and that explains all the available data. When we were talking about classification, we talked about two processes of classification, bottom-up process and a top-down process. In the bottom-up process of classification, we started with raw data and then grouped and abstracted it. In case of top-down classification, we started with some high-level class and then established it and refined it. You can see that in diagnosis, both the bottom-up process of classification and the top-down process of classification are co-occurring. This method of bottom-up classification in the data space, mapping into the hypothesis space, and then top-down classification in the hypothesis space is called heuristic classification. This is yet another method like rule-based reasoning, case-based reasoning, and model-based reasoning for the diagnostic task.